إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ستكون فتن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there will be afflictions in the near future. This is the fact mentioned by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. ستكون فتن. Trials will come. Another hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, هل ترون ما أرى؟ إني أرى مواقع الفتن خلال بيوتكم كمواقع القطر، أي المطر. Once the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stood at the top of one of the house in Medina, high house in Medina, and said, do you see what I see? Of course they did not see. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to see that. I'm seeing the spots of afflictions amongst your houses as numerous as the spots where rain drops fall. Fitan. And also he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, badiru bil a'mali فتنا كقطع الليل المظلم. Rush to do good deeds, fitna will occur that is like a portion of the dark night. Morning will come upon a man as a believer who will be a disbeliever in the evening, and evening will come upon a believer who will be a disbeliever in the morning. So, the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned fitan will come. Not everything in this life is nice. Not everything goes smooth as you wish, as you like. Fitna in your religion. You are confused where is the right and which one is wrong. And sometimes fitna, you know this is wrong, but your desire pushes you toward this fitna. Like the haram money, haram relationship, stealing, adultery, fitna, this is fitna. But always the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I mean the Sharia, will not let us without solution, without telling us how to save ourselves. So the same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned how to save yourself. This is the point. Brothers, sisters, maybe it is not the first time you hear this hadith, but we need this reminder. Jum'ah khutbah, to remind. It is not to mention something in you. Oh, this khatib, not mentioning something in you. Always he is reminding us. This is the point of Jum'ah khutbah, to remind people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing that. As the Sahaba mentioned, yudhakiruna. What does that mean, yudhakiruna? There is something here, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to refresh our memory, to remind us. Jum'ah khutbah, this member, this place, not to mention interesting stories. Wallah, we like to learn something new. This is not the place.
This is not the place to teach people new things. This is the place to remind people. The same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned a fitna, affliction will come. But he told us how to do, what to do, how to deal. ستكون فتن القاعد فيها خير من القائم والقائم خير من الماشي والماشي خير من الساعي. After he mentioned the fitna, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a sitting person will be better than a standing one. A standing one will be better than a walking one. Like that. Which means, don't be interested to know what is this fitna. Let's go outside to see what is happening. Let's go and check in this newspaper or that article what is happening. Save yourself, because as Muslims we know our religion from the Quran and Sunnah. Nothing new in Islam. Go back to Al-Amr Al-Awwal. In Islam, you should go back. In dunya, yes, we need the new things. The new mobile, the update, the cars, the houses, yes. But for the religion, go back. What do we mean by go back? You go back to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be safe. And if you notice the hadith we mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that what to do before telling us about the fitna. He said, "Badiru bil a'mali fitanan qita'an ka qita'i al-layli mudlim." He started by guiding us, because he knows we need the guidance. What is the point, brothers and sisters, when I talk about the fitna without telling how to save yourself? This is easy to tell you what are the fitna. But the main point, how to save yourself. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rush to do good deeds, a fitna will occur. Then he said the hadith. So, this is the way. Badiru bil a'mal. What is the meaning, badiru bil a'mal? Rush to the good deeds. Pray, fast, give zakah, say adhkar, read Quran, attend Quran classes, do da'wah, treat your parents in a nice way. Do the good deeds. This is the way how to save yourself. Which means, don't waste your time. You check this website, you check that place, you check this video. Don't waste your time, because we know our religion from the Quran and the Sunnah. One night the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam woke up. Then he said, Subhanallah, ماذا أنزل الله من الفتن? Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started by saying, Subhanallah, how many afflictions Allah has revealed tonight. And how many treasures have been sent down. Fitna and treasures. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, go and wake the sleeping lady occupants of these dwellings up. He means his wives. He means sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after telling about the fitan, he said, tell them to wake up. Why? To pray. Fajr salah? It is not fajr. It is qiyamul layl. Qiyamul layl can protect you? Yes. Qiyamul layl can protect you from the fitna. To be involved in the fitna. To be misguided in the fitna. Because this is part of the ibadah. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, رُبَّ كَاسِيَ فِي الدُّنْيَا عَارِيَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Perhaps a well-dressed in this world may be naked in the hereafter. She has a dress in this dunya, well covered, fully covered. But in the akhirah, she is naked. No good deeds, no righteous deeds. How to save yourself? فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Surah Al-An'am. Then why, when our punishment came to them, did they not humble themselves? How? By worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to humble yourself? You obey Allah. Put this head, this forehead, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Show your humility toward your Lord, the one who created you subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to save yourself? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umar radiallahu ta'ala, and one day asked about hadith al-fitan. Hudhaifa was there. Hudhaifa is a man, the man of secret of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Hudhaifa said to Umar radiallahu ta'ala, and I hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaking about the fitna. He said, فتنة الرجل في أهله وماله وجاره تكفرها الصلاة والصيام والصدقة. He said, the affliction of person in his property, family and neighbors is expiated by his prayers, fasting and giving in charity. Praying, fasting, charity. What is the relationship between the fitna and these deeds? Yes, because if you are busy in these good deeds, Allah will protect you from the fitna. My job is to pray, to fast, to give charity, to read Quran. Your job is not to go from with one video to another video, from one group to another group, wasting your time, confusing your brain. Muslim knows his religion from the Quran and the Sunnah. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a great hadith, hadith al-Irbad ibn Sariyah, radiyallahu ta'ala an, Sunan Abi Dawood al-Tirmidhi. One day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam delivered us a very eloquent khutbah on account of which eyes shed tears. ذرفت منها العيون. وجلت منها القلوب. Our hearts became very soft. This is the talk from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. كأنها موعظة مودع. As if he is giving a talk, leaving us. Which means he's going to die after this khutbah. Then we said, Ya Rasulullah, advise us. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I admonish you to fear Allah, to listen and obey even if an Abyssinian slave is appointed as your leader. Because whosoever among you shall live after me will see much discord. فَسَيَرَ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. A lot of fitna. A lot of fitna. I don't know, wallahi, this sheikh is right, the other sheikh is right. We are confused. We should do this, we should do that. Confusion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told you how to save yourself. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةُ خَلَفَاءَ الرَّاشِدِينَ مَهْدِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so hold fast to my sunnah and the examples of the rightly guided khalifs. This is the way, this is the correct way. We need to stick to the sunnah. Bite the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sunnah of Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Hassan, Abu Huraira, the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. What was the way of the companions? Hold that. You will be saved. This is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to save his ummah. قول ما تسمعون الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. أما بعد، يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، تركت فيكم أمرين لن تضلوا ما تمسكتم بهما، كتاب الله وسنة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. I have left two matters with you. As long as you hold to them, you will not go the wrong way. They are the book of Allah and the sunnah of his prophet. Very simple, صح? But why people are not following this hadith? You tell them this is a hadith, but this sheikh said that. This is the ayah. No, there is fatwa from another scholar. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. I am quoting from the Quran, the sunnah, and you are telling me this sheikh and that scholar, this da'iyah, this website, this unknown person, we don't know his name, we don't know his face, we don't know anything about him. Subhanallah. That's why you will find people in confusion, in fighting. Scatter the Muslim ummah. 73 sects. Hold the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the book of Allah. Read the Quran, understand the Quran. Use the Quran for your life, apply it in your life. For everything. The Quran, the sunnah, not only for the prayer and the zakah, the siyam, also for your family, for marital life, how to treat your children, the business transaction, everything about your life, in the Quran and the sunnah. This is the way to save yourself. You hold, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, لَن تَضِلُّ بَعْدِي. You will not be misguided after me. If you hold the Quran and the sunnah. So we need to check ourselves. Are we holding the Quran and sunnah or not? If you find the confusion, then this is a sign you are away from the Quran and the sunnah and the way of the companions. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And we should know the trials, the fitan, is not something new. The fitan, as the Prophet ﷺ told the companions, like the rain spots in between the houses of Sahaba, which means it is widespread the fitna. But how to save yourself? Al-ibadah. You worship Allah. How to save yourself? The Quran. How to save yourself? The Sunnah. How to save yourself also? The scholars. Al-Rabbaniyun, who take from the Quran and the Sunnah. Follow them. Follow their fatwa. Not the young people. This is one of the signs of the hereafter. أن يطلب العلم من الأصاغر. When you seek knowledge from أصاغر, people of بدعة, the young people, ignorant people, and you ignore the great scholars, this is wallahi مشكلة, a big problem. When we ignore the great scholars, the old scholars, the ages 70, 80, 90, no, they don't understand what is happening in this life. These scholars for the Salah, the rules of Salah, the rules of Wudu, the rules of fasting, but about the political issues, what is happening in the world, we go to this guy, he's maybe 25 or 35, subhanallah. What does he know? Maybe he doesn't know the Quran. I mean, he doesn't memorize the Quran. Maybe he doesn't know Arabic. You listen to these people and you ignore the scholars. This is one of the points to be into, to fall in the fitna. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. نعوذ بالله من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. نعوذ بالله من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. نعوذ بالله من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم اشفي أمير البلاد. اللهم وفق لا تأمور إلى ما تحب وترضى يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ إخوان المسلمين في غزة. اللهم آمن روعاتهم واستر عوراتهم. اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى من أيدي اليهود ومن عاونهم. اللهم عليك باليهود الغاصبين فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم وحد أمة الإسلام على التوحيد والسنة. اللهم اجمع كلمتنا على الحق. اللهم اجمع كلمتنا على الحق. اللهم اجمع كلمتنا على الحق. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات ومن المعاكسات. ومن وسائل التواصل الاجتماعي التي دمرت البيوت يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وتقبل صلاتنا وصيامنا وصدقاتنا. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.